So first we need to get a development environment. And there are several editors or IDE to develop Android. For example, you can use Eclipse to develop Android apps. But this time I'm going to use a software or IDE called Android Studio. So as this Wikipedia says, this Android Studio is the official IDE, integrated development environment for Google's Android operating system, and built on IntelliJ. So yeah, let's click this. And so I think you can download this Android Studio from here and install. I've already installed it, so I cannot show you the install screen, but I think it won't be so difficult. Okay, if you have installed Android Studio and activated it, then I think you see this kind of screen. But please note, they update this Android Studio pretty frequently, so maybe what you see is a bit different from this screen depending on when you watch this video, but I believe basic concept hasn't changed. And from here, this time we're gonna choose this start a new Android Studio project. So let's click this, and now it says select a project template. So as you can see, there are several options, and so they already prepared some template. Yeah, you can choose one of these templates. The page already has this map function or login function, stuff like that. But this time we're gonna make this from scratch. So we're gonna choose this one, no activity. And activity is kind of a Android Studio term, I believe. And basically it means page or screen, one screen. So yeah, let's choose this no activity and click this next. Okay, so now you see this screen, and first we're gonna type our project name. You can choose whatever name you want, but I think this time Jade's Adventure. Okay, and it automatically generated this package name and save location. And here, you can choose language from Kotlin or Java. And first, I think I'm gonna make this app's GUI. And the process of making this GUI will be the same, both in Java and Kotlin. So I will not repeat this process. So if you are interested in following this tutorial, then please watch this GUI part first. Then we go like a separate ways, Java or Kotlin. This time, I'm gonna choose Java, and here it says minimum SDK. This basically means what kind of API we're gonna use. So you can see these selections, and I believe this API 30 is the latest API. This API 14 is the oldest API that you can choose here. And so because, you know, Android is adding new features every month, every year. So sometimes if you use like a new API and make an app, then it cannot be run on old smartphones. So you can see the percentage here. It says your app will run on approximately 100% of devices. So basically every Android smartphone can run your app if you set this minimum SDK as API 14, but probably you cannot use kind of a latest features. And so for example, like if you set this API 28, approximately 39.5%. If API 25, 66%. You know, we're not gonna add any like fancy features or anything, so I think I'm gonna choose this lowest one, API 14. So let's finish. Okay, so this is Android Studio. And first, I recommend you to click here, Android, and change this from Android to project. This Android means kind of a simple version, it shows only its things, you know, necessary for you. But I prefer choose this project, then you can see everything, all the folders and everything. So either way is fine, but I always choose this project. There are many stuff here, folders and the files, and it looks a bit complicated. But I think you don't really have to worry about this Gradle and idea or idea and this Gradle. We will not use these three folders this time. So let's open this up. Here you can see lips and the source. And again, we are not gonna use this thing, but we're gonna use this one, source src folder. So let's open this. And here we only use this main. So don't worry about this Android test and the test. Let's open this main. And here we see this Java and the less and Android manifest. If you have some experience of Java, I think this looks kind of familiar. So basically this Java means Java code. And this REST is resource folder. And there are many folders, but I'm going to explain about this later. But basically this is where you put your resource, such as pictures. Yeah, so the preparation is done. So first, right click on this main. And from new, let's choose this activity, and this time we're gonna choose this empty activity. And so now we're gonna choose a name for this activity. And so this is gonna be our first screen. So I'm gonna name this as a title screen. This is gonna be the activity name. And the source language is Java. Also, make sure to check this launcher activity if you want to start your app from this screen. So this is like adding main method to this activity. You can set it manually later, but checking this now is easier. So yeah, let's click finish. Then it automatically generated this Java file and also this XML file inside of this layout folder. So this is the XML file, and here you can create the GUI, so how the screen looks like. So this Java file and XML file are kind of like a pair. So whenever you create an activity, it automatically generates Java file and XML file. For now, we don't use this Java file, but we use this XML file and design the screen first. So if this is your first time to use Android Studio, maybe this looks a bit overwhelming, so many things on the screen. So I'm gonna explain one by one, so don't worry. And first, let me explain this part of the screen. It says palette, and there are some choices like text, buttons, or layout, stuff like that. So you can choose a UI part from this palette section. For example, you can choose this text view and drag and drop around here. For example, here. And so this text view is for text. So you can display some text. And now you see this new section here. It says attributes. And it shows all the attributes about this text view right now. And yeah, many things. So ID or text. Like so many attributes, but you don't have to memorize everything, of course. We will use only few of them. So if you're interested, you can learn one by one, but for now, don't worry about it. And I'm gonna explain whatever we use. So first, among these attributes, let's see this text. And here, you can type whatever text you want. For example, like this is our Android game or something. And so the screen's a bit small, but like this. And also from here, it says text size, so you can change the font size like this. For example, 30sp, so font looks bigger now. And if you choose this button and drop around here, you can place button like this. And this button also has these attributes. And for example, so you can choose this text again and type like start. So like this. Okay. Next, let me explain this part of the screen, and it says component tree, and this shows the stuff you have already placed on the screen. We have placed this text view and also button, so it shows this stuff here. So you can check and select stuff here like this. Also, you can directly click like this. And then what about this one? It says constraint layout. So whenever you make an app on Android, basically you choose a layout, and from here, so you can see these layouts, like a constraint layout or linear layout or a table layout. So there's several options, and right now this constraint layout is the default layout of this Android Studio. Until, I don't know, 3-4 years ago, the Android Studio used a layout called relative layout as the default layout, but they introduced this new layout, constraint layout, a while ago, and so now this is the default layout. I think you can still choose relative layout from here, this legacy section. So anyway, on this layout, we just placed this text view and this button. Okay.